So Spiti is basically, you can say, Spiti literally means the middle land of Tibet, between Tibet and India.
Okay.
So this is towards the northeast side of Himachal. That's interior of Himachal Pradesh. Wow. Yeah, there's a laundry list of, you know, milestones and worth see or must see places in Spiti. But yes, crazy people obviously go to Spiti, I can say.
Okay.
Because of the weird terrain and the roads. There are basically no roads, you can say. There's a lot of off-roading, which is a part of the Spiti expedition.
Okay.
And yes, Spiti Valley itself is very beautiful. You have the valley together, you know, taking you through the terrain, the road, the rock-cut mountain roads totally. And you have a beautiful valley across. We had the samosa at one wet canteen, Amika, and then we were just going. So I was happily shooting everybody's videos and all. And I was with this co-rider. And by the time I could see all my fellow riders passing by, and I'm like waving to them, bye, it's okay, I'll catch you up. And this guy tells me, ki, I think there's a problem with the bike and it's really not starting. And then I realized we are in a soup.
Okay.
And there's nobody to, you know, see.
In the middle of nowhere.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Kilometers together and there's nobody absolutely. And our riders had already gone. And one more thing that I realized was that none of us are carrying the BSNL SIM because that's the only thing that works there.
Okay. That's the only carrier that works.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, and I was like, okay, so now what do we do? And our backup vehicle was never with us.
So the backup vehicle actually follows you.
Yeah, normally it's supposed to follow us, but
okay.
In this particular entire trip, it was never with us. So there were these two workers who were already packing up and leaving for the day because it was already 7 in the evening and it was getting dark.
Okay.
So luckily I had the last dialed the number of my friend.
Okay.
And I took his phone and I dialed this number. And this guy, luckily he picked up the call because normally we are not supposed to answer calls when we are riding. But since, you know, he could not trace us in the rear mirror, he waited and that's when I called him.
Right.
So we told him that, you know, there's this village ahead and just see if you can get a mechanic or somebody or some help. And by the time we got help, so this Archie bhai of ours, you know, came like a superman with some local guy with him and, you know, with some rope. And we did some kind of a circus there. We tied the bike to his bike and then he had to drag to some few kilometers, like 10 kilometers, I think he literally dragged the bike. Then we found some mechanics there who gave us some local assistance, and that's how we finally could reach the destination at what, 12:30 in the night. So it was an adventure for us, which we will obviously remember for lifetime.
Wow.